fondest memories is looking up this last year in 2019 and seeing the sea of people and seeing like three different circle pits going at the same time. And that was fantastic.
Yeah.
And I can't really see that far. For me to be able to pick that out, I was like, holy fucking shit, then it gave me butterflies really bad.
And then
I fucked up.
We never even did like an intro.
No.
Hey, Wasteland Weekend, we're Dead Animal Assembly Plant.
What's up?
And we miss you guys so fucking much, and we just wanted to say hello and share with you some of our favorite Wasteland stories.
How about the guy with the Polaroid?
Dude, that fucking guy.
Sorry, Fridge.
Yeah. Yeah, when we were practicing, the guy who had that beautiful speech about the togetherness of everyone.
I wish I could remember any of it.
Mm-hmm. It was just about the unity and everyone kind of being, you know, being together as one, and then he took the fucking Polaroid, and I have it hanging on the fridge.
That was a fantastic moment.
You know, speaking of all the events that were going on inside, like, Wasteland was, it's just, you can go to a dildo race, come on now. Wasteland that we went to that, we're like, what the fuck is happening?
Yeah, like, we walk in, awesome. And they're like, here, do you want a
whiskey pickle?
Whiskey pickle?
Fuck yeah, dude.
And then we watched fucking vibrator races, and...
This last year, I immediately needed a welder, because Zach's mic stand fucking broke, and I immediately was just like, come on in, here's the welder, here's the fucking hood, fucking weld it. And it's just shit like that just makes everything, the community, and it's just fucking really awesome, actually.
It's just a surreal community. It's fucking amazing.
Yeah.
So much.
Can we just live there? Can we just have it go? Could it just be like a thing?
I was feeling so nostalgic in January. God, man. Even when you leave, you just get nostalgic. You just kind of want to sit in that desert and just like chill out.
Yeah, the minute you leave, you start missing it.
Yep. Dude. And the 2 years that we've been there, we've always had to leave.
And just like hanging out at the Wasted Saints camp and all their crazy shows that they have at night. And you know, all the people that you meet. And even when that's the only time that you ever see them, it's like no time has passed. Mm-hmm. It's like that instant, it's like that family connection. The first time we went, I got to meet Ganzito, and he made me this, and I've been able to fucking carry it with ever since and have it on tour. And it's just, you know, the whole trade system there, it's just, it's phenomenal. There's nothing else like it.
But shit, being on the stage is just one thing. I mean, in 2018, the fire, blasting, man, that added a whole spark of just stage presence.
Yeah, Jared's stage is fantastic, and it is quite the piece of work. And
solid crew, solid.
And Chino Sounds, shout out to Chino Sounds.
Yes.
Oh my God, love Todd. I mean, he's always amazing to work with. Jared and his crew are always amazing to work with. I mean, is this so much fun?
Hey, Wastelanders, this is Zero. I know 2020 has been kind of a shit show. We're very, very sorry. Unfortunately, obviously, we weren't able to actually come back this year. Nobody was. Hopefully, next year, we'll be able to actually come back and perform for you. We miss you guys terribly. The community, the bands, everybody else that actually is involved with this. You know, one of the greatest things is actually performing for you guys. You guys' crowd is something that's unheard of anywhere else. I think that's one of the biggest things I miss, is just getting to know the people that are actually off the stage as well as on the stage. Everybody, as far as the sound and the lighting, everybody that just puts their all into that type of festival is something that hopefully we'll be able to actually perform for you next year. Thank you guys so much. Hope to see you next year.